Welcome back to Daily Connections. If it takes forever to find the exact piece of jewelry you want to wear each day, we have some tips on how to store your jewelry. And here to share this information is our house and home expert, Gina Stege. Hi, Gina.
Hi, Tracy.
How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Awesome. Good to see you.
Thanks.
So you're going to show us a little bit of what to do with our jewelry that's just stuffed in a box.
And absolutely. We've all got great jewelry, and I particularly love to wear it, and I found that I wasn't wearing it when it was stored in a drawer. Mm-hmm. You're not seeing it, and when you're getting dressed in the morning, and a lot of us are rushing out, you don't have time to start pulling out drawers and little tiny boxes and things. So having it out and, on display, almost like a store would do it.
Okay.
So you think of it like shopping your own accessories.
That's a really good idea, because I myself am a culprit with, they're all in one little box or a couple little boxes, and I tend to end up wearing the same things all the time.
Sure.
Just because I know it's comfortable, it's right there, and
that's it. And years go by and you forget you even had some things.
That's right.
Also, things tend to break when they're just shoved in a box.
Okay.
You're not taking good care of them. A lot, obviously, of jewelry is very delicate. So you want to take care of it, store it properly, and make sure that you can use it and enjoy it.
And then get it on a nice display, especially with people who are looking for additional accents to their rooms.
Well, that's the thing. People have trouble sometimes decorating a bedroom, keeping it that oasis that we've talked about in the past, and making it special and pretty and feminine and romantic. And really, that's what jewelry is.
It's a great way to beautify.
It's a great accessory for your room as well as for yourself.
I agree with you.
There you go.
That's nice. So you're going to show me
some of the things that we have
These
are all things we found in stores, and they really are reminiscent of what an actual store could use to display their own things.
Okay.
So they're sort of based on that. This actually reminds me of a cake stand.
It does.
Stand, a vintage dessert stand, and this is for earrings. And the great thing about this is that each one spins around, so they're very easy to find what you're looking for. And then they've got these trays on them, and this one has little, I don't know if you can see it, but it has little divisions in the trays. This is great for like earring backs or little tiny
extra
studs.
Little things, right?
Sure.
Or the ones that don't hang.
Right.
Like
the little,
those in
the
there,
little
right?
posts and studs and things like that. So they can all sit in there. You could put bracelets up here or other things. But this is a beautiful piece.
This is awesome.
Yeah.
And you said that this was actually affordable.
It is. It's from a catalog. It's
actually,
it's from a catalog that caters to teenagers. But, take a look. So things may show up in unexpected places for you. You may not find them where you think they are.
Got it.
But this, like I said, it sits on my dresser, and it's really quite attractive, and I can see everything very quickly.
You really can. And then you can really, make better decisions about all the jewelry that you have.
Yep.
I really like this. And with the little ones up there, medium.
Right, you can separate them either maybe, the silver, the gold, or the sort of sparkly ones, or by their length.
Back to the 80s at the bottom.
There you go.
I got a lot of those.
Yep.
But they always come back in style, too. That's another thing.
They do. And if it's something that you love but maybe isn't fashionable right now, you can hang on to it because you'll have room for it and just appreciate it for its beauty. I mean, these are very sparkly and pretty in the room.
I love that. I'm sure when everyone comes into your room, they go right to that.
They do.
They do, right?
They do.
That is so cool. That's beautiful. I really like that.
So that's for earrings and some other little things too. This is really cool. This is also for earrings, and we found this in a store also catering to the young folk.
Is that right? The teens?
Sure. And I guess, they're at that age as well where they've got lots. And this is better for more delicate earrings.
Okay.
And
I guess your pearls
it's
up
literally
here.
What we're doing is taking the jewelry and making it art because you're framing it.
Wow.
So it's a really neat way to take something, as I said, that's beautiful, have it function because everything on here is going to, nothing's going to get tangled this way.
All of your
things will be taken care of and you can see them at a glance.
This is really good too because, you always lose things.
Yes.
And this is a great way to not lose things.
Yes. It keeps it organized.
Especially the earring backs.
Yes. The earring backs are on here holding them in place so you know that they're always together. You're not scrounging around at the bottom
looking
of a drawer for those little
pieces,
teeny tiny earrings.
That match. This one hurts. This one doesn't.
This one falls off all of the time.
Right. I really love that. So you have it right on the back there.
Yes.
So everything's
just
right there.
Through.
Now, did you buy this like this with the screen?
I did. And later on, we'll show you how you can make one of your own because it's quite simple.
Really?
Yeah.
Awesome. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So you could just put earrings and everything on that. Very nice. And we have the birdie.
This is also, and these are all vintage inspired. I will tell you that there are things on the market, and we'll show you how you can make some too that are more contemporary. So you can find something that's in keeping with your decor in your bedroom.
Got it.
And and sort of coordinates with your jewelry. If your jewelry's more contemporary, then you can find these things
in a
contemporary style. Sure. But this is a little vintage looking piece, and that's for bracelets.
But that's so great.
Yeah.
Though. I love that. Do you have this out too?
Yep. They're all sort of out as a display on top of the dresser. Mm-hmm. And again, once you see them, you're more apt to wear them.
Mm-hmm.
These were my grandmother's. They're very old. Okay. And, you know, they were at the bottom of a drawer. I forgot I had them. You know,
really?
I literally forgot I had them. Mm-hmm. And they're such a fun color. And, you know, when I see them in the morning, I'm much more apt to say, oh, you know what? I have that color in my outfit, or I have a very plain outfit. So, mm-hmm. you know, let's pull that fun pop of color.
So you do wear them more that they're
out. I wear
out.
Them so much more. Yeah, I wear all my jewelry now that I have it out and
That's
accessible.
That's good. And I see you have nice jewelry on today.
Yep.
It's so beautiful.
Yeah.
But you can always, I like that. You can really accessorize
when
and
you're
modify.
Getting dressed, you know, most people have a full-length mirror in their bedroom.
Right.
So it's very simple to pull and say, no, and then grab another one. And it's literally like you're in a fitting room in a store where you're grabbing things and seeing how it looks together.
Makes so much more sense, right, than fumbling through drawers. You have no idea what's in here, and then you give up.
Right, exactly.
I'll just wear the old standard thing.
Right, I'll just wear my everyday jewelry. People have things that they just wear every day and forget about it.
Yep.
So this is a traditional jewelry box, and it's very pretty, it's decorative, and I'm not saying that you should never have a traditional jewelry box. Those are great for really the more valuable things, things maybe that are more intricate that you don't want to expose to dust or things like that
right.
are out.
Because that was a little bit of my concern, having these things out. So you have another place for the things that are delicate.
Right, or tiny,
or
really tiny.
Even,
exactly. So, you know, we have some things, and these have trays in them, and there's plenty of room. There's a little mirror in it. These absolutely have their place. But again, if you have, they make them now that are so big and intricate that it would take you half an hour just to find what you're looking for, you're not going to wear it. So the mirror is nice also, so you can check, you know,
that's
maybe
great.
how it looks on you and things like that.
So it's got the top little bins, and then you have the big one underneath.
Right, and that would be for larger pieces.
And this is good too, because you can find, if you're doing vintage pieces, you can find a vintage box, so you know that, you know, they match together.
Right,
kind of
absolutely. And, you know, again, this is matching and sort of coordinating with the other pieces that I have, but they come very contemporary. Yeah, and you want to match it to your room.
And especially things that are handed down from generation. Mm-hmm. That's always like a nice box for that stuff.
Right,
that's
exactly. So this is a really pretty piece, and this is a stand that, again, we found in a store, but it's for something really special. This, again, is a vintage necklace. It's quite large. Now, if you were to take this off and throw it in a box, I mean, it could you could see how it already gets
all
tangled.
Tangled up.
Yeah, so, you know, it's such a beautiful piece, and I have to say, you're probably not going to wear this every day.
Right.
So why not appreciate it? You know, this, a lot of these things are costly. So having one special piece on a special stand really, again, makes it art. You know, this could stand in for a framed photo on a, you know, nightstand
totally
or what
have you. I totally agree with you. You know, these are such great ideas. I never would have thought of this, but this is so great. Now, where did you get this piece?
Again, it's from a store that caters to younger people.
Really?
I don't know why, but
what's up with that?
We have to
the younger people.
I know.
Getting all the good stuff.
But you know what? It's fun to go and look in those stores and see. And you know, like I said, this on a nightstand is just a beautiful piece
Gorgeous.
To look at.
Yep.
You know, and I am more apt to wear it when it's out and visible.
And talk about it too, because if this was an item that you got handed down from generation to generation,
they're special
people
pieces.
See it and you can just talk about it.
Yeah, even if you don't wear it. I know, you know, I know folks that get things handed down and they would never ever wear something this bold, but it means something to them. So having
it
on display,
appreciating
it for its beauty.
That's awesome. I love that. And finally, this piece.
Similarly, these now you will find really in a lot of different shapes and sizes. Sometimes they're just a wire frame or, you know, it's obviously a miniature mannequin.
This is amazing.
Yeah,
I
it's really, really pretty. And, you know, we have a necklace on here. You can also put, these are just brooches.
The pins.
You could cover the whole thing with brooches.
That's what I would do, because where do you put the pins?
Where do you put the pins? And you know, a
so
lot
you can
of
stick
things,
that right in it?
Yeah, it's got like a softness to it that will receive the pin.
Great.
And a lot of things with rhinestones things, those are the stones that tend to pop out.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's right.
My goodness, how hard it is to find a little tiny stone. So if they're in a jewelry box, they're going to get knocked around.
Right.
This keeps them while you can still see their beauty, and they're safe and you know,
this
able
is
to
gorgeous.
Be used.
Yeah, I love
isn't pretty?
That. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
And what's so great about all of this is that it's very affordable. It's not ridiculously
it's
expensive.
It's not. And we can even show you how to do it for less, because we're going to make some things.
What we're going to do it. In a little bit. You're going to show us how to do some of these actually ourselves.
Absolutely, yes.
Good. Excellent, Gina. Thank you very much for this. This is good
You're
stuff.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.
Okay.